class, good evening to all of you. I welcome you all again to the second session of this polynomial in this Umang sprint series. Right, so today we'll be discussing about the second session of this polynomial, and as all of you know that we are doing this in the flash mode or in the sprint mode, that is quick, right? So all the concepts which you have already done, we are just covering the most important topics in this whole chapter, right? So in the last class we have done with the basics, we have done with the addition, we have done with the subtraction, and in this class we'll move ahead, we'll be doing multiplication, division and factorization, right? So let's move ahead now and solve some questions. So this is the timetable which we have done. Number system has been already be over, and now we are continuing with the topic polynomials, right? So yesterday I solved this question. Okay, there is a huge thing yesterday. This question was subtract 4xy minus xy x square y from this part, and actually what I did, I subtracted in a way that I subtracted this from this, but actually it was inverse. So all of you got it correct. Those who gave me the correct answer, I know that was a mistake. So it was an English mistake which I didn't focus, right? So what was the mistake? I will tell you here, that subtract this from this. So that means this from this part, we will subtract this polynomial. So we have to subtract from 5x square minus 5x plus 1, and here 4x square minus 5x plus 1. And since we are doing subtraction, minus plus minus, this got cancelled. 4x square minus 5x square minus 4x square is x square, and minus x plus 5x is plus 4x. So the answer will be x square plus 4x, which is given correct to by many students. And many students told me that, sir, this was the mistake, you have done the from part, which is absolutely correct. I did not notice this part. So yes, it is true. So we have to solve this equation like from x square y minus 2xy, we will subtract 4xy minus 4x square y. So this is all correct. Don't make this mistake in examination which I have made, right? So let's move ahead now. So this was the question which I have told you what was the mistake there. And whenever it is like subtract this from this, so from the second part we will subtract the first one. It is same as subtract 8 from 10, so we'll do 10 minus 8, right? So let's move ahead now. So this was the homework question and the answer which we have seen, and the correct answer has been given to me by these many students, Ram, Priyanshu, and this is one Lunatic Logic, and I hope I'll get your real name right, and Shivam, Bhupendra and Sumukha. Okay, so these are the students who have given me correct answers. Do keep answering the correct answers and your name will be featured in the next videos. So let's move on with today's topic. So today we'll be discussing about, as I've told you, multiplication, division and the factorization, right? So the first question is the following equation true or false? So that means this into this is equal to this. So how do we get it? There is only one way, multiply these two. Let us check whether LHS will be equal to RHS or not. So when I multiply x plus 1 with x square plus x plus 1, you will be getting, let me shift it there, you will be getting x into x square plus x plus 1, and then plus 1 into x square plus x plus 1, right? Now let's multiply this thing, so you'll be getting x cube plus x square plus x plus x square plus x plus 1. So you are getting x cube plus 2x square plus 2x plus 1. Okay, so this is what your solution will be, but they are asking that is it equal to x cube plus 1? So absolutely no, it is not correct. So we will say this following equation is not true, as simple as that. Correct? Easy, right? Easy. So let's move ahead now. And the next question we have is this. Find the product of x minus 1 into x plus 1 into x plus 2. Okay, so let's multiply these two. As we know, the associative property that out of three numbers, if I multiply any two and then multiply the third one, my answer will remain same. That means I'm telling you that suppose if you are given 1 into 2 into 3, so if you multiply 1 and 2 first, that is 1 into 2 is 2, into 3 will be 6, or 2 into 3 into 1, or 1 into 3 into 2. So no matter in what groups you will multiply them, your answer will be same. So since I have to multiply these three, so I can start with multiplying these two first, and whatever answer I'll be getting, that I will multiply to the third one at the end. So I will do this like what I'll say. Ki chalo sir, this is x minus 1 into x plus 1 into x plus 2. So this will become x minus 1 into x plus 1 into x plus 2. So what I'll do, sir, I'll multiply x minus 1 into x plus 1 first, and I know it is the identity a minus b into a plus b. As you can see, suppose if your x is a and 1 is b, so you'll be getting this is as a form of a minus b into a plus b, which is a square minus b square, right? So this will become x square minus 1 into x plus 2. Now let's multiply x square minus 1 into x plus 2. So we know that this bracket, whatever terms are there, that all the terms, each and every term, will be multiplied to the bracket, to the whole other bracket. So first multiply this x square with x plus 2, and then multiply this minus 1 with x plus 2. So what you are getting, x into x square, x cube, x square into 2 plus 2x square, minus 1 into x is minus x, and minus 1 into 2 is minus 2. So you are getting x cube plus 2x square minus x minus 2. So this is what will be your product of x minus 1 into x plus 1 into x plus 2. Okay, so I hope it is clear to all of you right now, right? So let's move ahead to the next question. So the next question will be this. Find the zeros of the polynomial for px is equal to x square plus 2x plus 1. So we have to find out the zeros. That means we have to find out the factors of this equation. From factors I will get zeros, right? From factors I can get zeros. So I have to factorize this quadratic equation. And we know we can factorize the quadratic equation by doing splitting the middle term, right? What do you guys have to do? To find the zeros, we need to factorize this equation first. So what we'll do? We'll say, sir, x square plus 2x plus 1, right? This factorization has to be done. So whenever we have to do the factorization of a quadratic equation of ax square plus bx plus c form, we know that we need to split this x term in such a way, such that suppose we compare this with the equation ax square plus bx plus c. So we need to do splitting in such a way that whatever two numbers I'm choosing, their product should be equal to, their addition should be equal to b, and whatever two numbers I'm choosing, their multiplication should be equal to the multiplication of a into c, right? So what is my a here? My a is 1, c is also 1, so a into c will become 1. And what is my b here? My b is 2. So what are two numbers which I have whose addition will be plus 2 and whose multiplication will be 1? So as all of you know easily, sir, the numbers will be 1 1 1 1. Are it all went black? Chalo, no problem. Okay, 1 1 1 1, right? So 1 plus 1 will be 2, 1 into 1 will be 2. So what we'll be writing, this will be written as x plus x plus 1. Now from these two terms, take x common. So you have got take x common, it will be left with x plus 1. Same common you should get from these two terms only. So x plus 1 we should get same. If I have taken x plus 1 common, that means plus 1 is taken common. So you'll be getting x plus 1 into x plus 1. So these are the two factors, right? So from here I can say first 0 I can get as x plus 1 is equal to 0. That means x is equal to minus 1. And from here you can say x plus 1, again the same thing. So x is equal to minus 1. So we are getting the zeros of the polynomial x is equal to what? Minus 1, right? So this is the easiest method. Also, if you can see that it is following the property of a square plus 2ab plus b square. So directly you can use the identity that it is the form of when a is equal to x and b is equal to 1, it is following the property of a square plus 2ab plus b square. That means its product, its factorization will be a plus b whole square, that is x plus 1 whole square. And from there you can say that x is equal to minus 1 is a root of this polynomial, right? Let's move ahead now. And the next question we have is this. If both x plus 1 and x minus 1 are the factors, both x plus 1 and x minus 1 are the factors of ax cube plus x square minus 2x plus b, find A and B. Now, x plus 1 and x minus 1 are the factors. So, from here, I can say, sir, if x plus 1 is factor, x plus 1 equal to 0 will be give me my root. That means x is equal to minus 1 is a root. And from here, x minus 1 equal to 0 will give me a root. So, x is equal to 1 is a root. So, these are the two roots or two zeros of this polynomial. Okay. Now, tell me, Achyu, what do you mean by zeros? That means the numbers, the values of x for which the value of that polynomial will become zero. That is what do we mean by solution of a polynomial or zeros of a polynomial or roots of an equation. That means the values of the variable for which this whole value will be equal to zero. Correct? So, it means that at x is equal to minus 1, if I put x is equal to minus 1 here, this will become equal to 0. And if I put x is equal to 1 here, then also this will become 0. That means, let us say this is my px. This is a polynomial px. So, we know that p of minus 1 will be equal to 0 because at x is equal to minus 1 is a root. And p of 1 will also be equal to 0. The values of the polynomial px at minus 1 and 1 will be equal to 0. So, let us try that. So, we will put x is equal to minus 1. So, p minus 1 will be getting as, put x is equal to minus 1. Okay. So, we will be getting minus 1 cube is minus 1 only. So, minus a plus minus 1 square is plus 1. Then, minus 2 into minus 1 will become plus 2 and plus b. And this will be equal to 0. So, from here, we'll get an equation. What will be that equation? That b minus a, 1 plus 2 is 3, is equal to minus 3. B minus a is equal to minus 3. And let us put p is equal to 1. So, p is equal to 1. What we are getting here? When we put p is equal to 1, so you'll be getting a plus 1 minus 2. Because minus 2 into 1 is minus 2 plus b, right, is equal to 0. So, from here, we are getting that a plus b and 1 minus 2 is minus 1. So, minus 1 shifted there will become plus 1, right? So, these are the two things which we have got. B minus a is equal to minus 3 and a plus b is equal to 1, right? What we have done? We have put the value of x is equal to minus 1 here in this equation. So, minus a plus 1 minus and plus 2 plus b. Then, we put x is equal to 1. So, a plus 1 minus 2 plus b. So, we have got two equations. Now, what we can do ahead? We know that these are the two equations. So, from here, can I get the value of a, let us say a. So, let's shift this a here and minus 3 there. So, this will become b minus 3 shifted there will become plus 3 is equal to a. Yes or no? B plus 3 is equal to what I've done? I've shifted this a here and minus 3 there. So, minus 3 will become plus 3 minus a will become plus a. This value of a, which is b plus 3, can I put it here in this equation? Yes. So, let's put this value here in this equation. So, you'll be getting b plus 3 in place of a plus b is equal to 1. So, now 2b plus 3 is equal to 1. Shift this 3 to that side, you'll be getting 2b is equal to minus 2. That means b is equal to minus 1. Now, b is equal to minus 1. How do we get a? This b is equal to minus 1. We can put any of this equation. Let us put it here. Since we know a plus b is equal to 1, we know that a plus b is equal to 1. And if b is minus 1, I will say a minus 1 is equal to 1 because b is minus 1. Shifted there, you'll get a is equal to 2. You will get a is equal to 2. So, these are the values of b and a. Okay. So, some of you might not be aware of this, but linear equation in two variables, when we are getting two equations in two variables, what we can do? We can get the value of one variable from the first equation and that value we can substitute in the second one. So, this way we can solve both the values, right? So, this is a bit tough problem, but I hope now by this example, you must have understood it, how to solve these kind of problems, right? Chalo. So, let's move to the next part. So, the next question is this. Find the value of the polynomial 3x cubed minus 4x square plus 7x minus 5 when x is equal to 3 and also when x is equal to minus 3. So, this is very easy. Value of the polynomial at 3 or minus 3, that means simply they are asking, well, suppose this px, polynomial px is given as what? 3x cube minus 4x square plus 7x minus 5. So they are asking you find the value of this polynomial at 3 and at minus 3. These two simple things they are asking. That means put x is equal to 3 and get your values, right? So you'll be getting 3 into 3 cube, that is 3 cube is 27 into 3, which is 81, minus 3 square is 9, 9 into 4, minus 36, 7 into 3 is plus 21, minus 5. So what you are getting? You are getting 81 plus 21 and 36 minus 5, minus 36 minus 5 will give you minus 41, and minus 41 from 81 will give you, suppose, 40, 40 plus 21, 61, right? 61. Let me check it again, 81. Correct, 61, right? So P of 3 at value 3 at x is equal to 3, the value of this polynomial is 61. Now let us check it at P of minus 3. So at minus 3, this will become x cube. So minus 3 into minus 3 into minus 3, which is minus 27. Minus 27 into 3 will become minus 81. Then x square, so minus 3 into minus 3 is 9 only, 9 into minus 4 will again be minus 36. Then 7 into minus 3, which will become minus 21, and then it will become minus 5. So what you'll be getting, so in the last time it was, this is 36 and 36 plus 41, 41, and now this is 102, so 100 plus 141, 143. So minus 143 will be your answer, right? So this is how we can solve this very easily. Just very simple problem, very simple problem, right? Just the value of the polynomial they have asked. Let's move ahead now. And the next question is, find the value of k if x minus 1 is a factor of this. Okay. Now, let us understand this question properly. If they are saying that x minus 1 is a factor. X minus 1 is a factor. That means when I factorize this, x minus 1 will be one of the factor. And what does the factor gives us? The factor gives us a root of that polynomial, right? So we will be getting x minus 1 is a factor. That means x minus 1 is equal to 0 is a root. If it is a factor, then I know that if I make it equal to 0, I will get a root. So I will get x is equal to 1 is a root of this equation. Correct? Now, since it is a root of this equation, then that means if I put x is equal to 1 here, let us say this is of px. So I know that if x is equal to 1 is a root, that means p of 1 is equal to 0, because at a root the value of the polynomial becomes 0, right? So p of 1 will be equal to 0. So let us put x is equal to 1 here, and that answer should be equal to 0. So we'll say 4 into 1 cube plus 3 into 1 square minus 4 into 1 plus k should be equal to 0. So what we are getting? 4 plus 3 minus 4 plus k is equal to 0. This to this got cancelled. That means you got k is equal to minus 3. So k is equal to minus 3 is the value of k for which x minus 1 will be a factor. So the use of factors is they will give us a root. The use of factor is they will give us a root. Understand? So this is the main part here. Let's move to the next question. The next question we have is this. Find the value of the polynomial 3x cube minus 4x square plus 7x minus 5 when x is equal to 3. Achha, this we have solved. Factorize 5y is equal to 36 minus. Array, what I'm moving ahead. Factorize 5y is equal to 36 minus y square. Okay. Now, how do we solve it? Very quickly, we'll solve it, bacho. Okay, so you have been asked to factorize 5y is equal to 36 minus y square. Okay, now remember this thing. When you can see that this is a quadratic equation, we have to factorize it, and nothing will be common here. So what we'll do, we'll shift everything to one side and we'll keep it. Let's shift all this RHS to LHS so that when I shift it there, I will get minus y square as y square. So I'll be getting y square, and 5y was already there. Minus 36 equal to 0, and now it is a quadratic equation which I can easily solve. What I need two numbers such that their addition is equal to the coefficient of b, which is 5, and such that their product is equal to A into C, which is 1 into minus 36, that means minus 36. So what are those two numbers? What do you think? Two numbers such that when you add them, you are getting 5. When you multiply them, you are getting minus 36. Now remember, bacho, whenever you are getting multiplication as negative, that means out of these two, one number have to be negative. Not two, only one. And only one number has to be negative. If this product is positive, then we don't know whether the product, when both numbers can be positive also, both the numbers can be negative also. But I know that only one has to be negative. So if you don't know what you will do, you will write all the factors of 36. So 36, all the factors, if we write, it is 1 and 36, 2 and 18, then 3 and 12, and 4 and 9. Then 6 and 6. Now we know one of them has to be positive, so the pairs of these factors should be chosen in such a way, these two, any one pair will be in such a way such that your addition, subtraction anyway should be equal to 36, and we want the sum as 5. So multiply any one of the pair, you will always getting 36, but we want the sum as 5. And I know minus 36, that means 1 have to be negative. So let us find out their subtraction. This is 35, this is 16, this is 9, but this subtraction will give you 5. 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. So from here I got to know that, sir, here I will put 9, here minus 4, so 9 into minus 4, so we know both the things are satisfied, right? So let us write now. So you'll be getting y square plus 9y minus 4y minus 36 equal to 0. Okay, so what you'll be getting, take y common. So when you take y common, y into y plus 9, then minus, same thing you should get here common as well. So from minus 4y, what you have taken common so that only y is left, you have taken minus 4 common. So minus 4 into 9 is what? Minus 36 only again. So take y plus 9 common. So when you take y plus 9 common, you will be left with y minus 4. So these are the factorization, y plus 9 into y minus 4. So this way easily we can solve it. If you are not able to get the numbers, just write the factors of this product part and then check. Okay, you'll get your answer. Then the next question we have is this: find the zeros of the polynomial this px. Okay, you have to find the zeros of this polynomial x minus 2 whole square minus of x plus 2 whole square. So again, we don't have anything to do. I know that I have to use a minus b whole square and a plus b whole square, right? So what I'll be starting with, I can say, or you can do it this way also, that you can see that it is a square minus b square also. So there are two ways to doing it. Let's do it by anyways, we can solve it. So let us first solve it using identities. Okay, using identities. So using identity, which identity I'll be using? I'll be using identity a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b, right? So here I will say, let us say x minus 2 is equal to a and x plus 2 is equal to b. So you can see this is a square minus b square. So x minus 2 whole square minus x plus 2 whole square will be equal to a plus b. That means x minus 2 plus x plus 2 into a minus b. So x minus 2 minus of whole b. So whole b is what? X plus 2. So minus of x minus 2. So here you will see minus 2 and plus 2 will get cancelled. So you are getting 2x, and here into x minus 2. So this 2x minus will get cancelled. Minus 2 into minus 4 is minus 4. So you are getting this as minus 8x. The polynomial is what? Polynomial px is equal to minus 8x, and this will be equal to 0 when x is equal to 0, as simple as that. Correct? Minus 8x put equal to 0, so you will get x is equal to minus 0 upon minus 8, which is x is equal to 0. So x is equal to 0 is the root. Other ways you can expand it, you can expand the values a minus b whole square and a plus b whole square. So you will be getting x square plus 4 minus 4. X square plus 4 minus 4x, because a minus b whole square, right? So a square plus b square minus 2 into x into 2, so you are getting minus 4x. Then minus of x square plus 4 plus 4x, right? So let us subtract them. So x square plus 4 minus 4x, open the bracket, minus x square minus 4 minus 4x. This to this got cancelled, this to this got cancelled. Minus 4x minus 5, 4x is minus 8x only. Make it equal to 0, you will get x is equal to 0. So by any way, you can solve it. By any method, it can be solved. Either you can take it as a square minus b square, or you can directly expand it. Your answer will remain same. And the zeros will be equal to what? 0. X is equal to 0 is the 0 of this polynomial, right? Let's move ahead now. Okay, both x minus 2 and x is equal to x minus half are factors of px square plus 5x plus r. Show that p is equal to r. Show that p is equal to r. So again, if you will see here that your x minus 2 and x minus half are factors. So whenever they are giving you factors, they are trying to tell you that what are the roots. So from here, I will get that let's make it equal to 0. Make it equal to 0. So you will get x is equal to 2 is a root. And from here you will get x is equal to half is a root. This polynomial, find, show that p is equal to r. So I don't have anything else to do rather than putting x is equal to 2 in this and putting x is equal to half in this and make it equal to 0. So when put x is equal to half or x is equal to 2, I'll be getting this in this part. P into 2 square is 4. So 4p plus 5 into 2, which is 10, plus r, okay, is equal to 0. So what we are getting? 4p plus 10 plus r equal to 0. And when I put x is equal to half, I am getting 4p into 1 by 2 into 1 by 2. So p by 4 plus 5 by 2, that is 5 by 2 plus r is equal to 0. Okay, so again you will see here that this is again two variables we are getting here. So we have to get their values properly. So what we can do here is we can do the subtraction part here. See, if I subtract these two equations, I know, let us subtract these two equations, both are equal to 0. So let us subtract these two equations. Okay, so what will happen here? Minus, minus, minus. So this two get cancelled. R minus R. So I have removed one variable, and 4P minus P by 4. So 4P minus P by 4, if you will subtract, what you'll be getting? 4P minus P by 4. So take LCM, 4P minus P by 4. So 16P minus P, which is 15P by 4. And then here we have 10 minus 5 by 2. So it will become plus 10 minus 5 by 2, so that is 20 minus plus 15 by 2 is equal to 0. Correct? Shift it to that side, you are getting 15 p by 4 is equal to minus 15 by 2. This to this cancelled, you are getting 4, shift 4 there, you are getting p is equal to minus 2. Now, how do we get the value of r? Put p is equal to minus 2 in any of the equation. So let us put p is equal to minus 2 in the first equation. 4 into minus 2 plus 10 plus r is equal to 0. So you are getting minus 8 plus 10 plus r equal to 0. That means 2 plus r equal to 0. So from here I have got r is equal to minus 2. And you can see p and r both are equal to minus 2. So we will be getting p is equal to r. Okay. P is equal to R. So this is a bit tough problem. Whenever you are getting two variables, it becomes a bit tough. But I know by now many of you must have learned how to solve this pair of linear equation in two variables. If not, I'll be conducting that soon. But just one method is either you can substitute, or here I saw that this R and R, if I subtract these two equations, this R will get cancelled. So I removed that R and solved for P. Okay, so these are some of the operations which you can do with the equations. Like you can add two equations, you can subtract two equations, you can replace the values of one variable from the other. So these are some of the ways which you should learn to solve these kind of problems. Okay, so I hope all of you enjoyed this problem, and let's move on to the next problem, which is this. Determine which of the following polynomial has x minus 2 as a factor. So it's very easy. If x minus 2 is a factor, that means x minus 2 is a factor. What does it mean? That x is equal to 2 is a root. I have told you, the use of factor is only to give you roots, okay? So, just put x is equal to 2 here. So, what you are getting? 3 into 2 square 4. 4 into 3, which is what? 12 plus 6 into 6. 6 into 2, 12 minus 24, which is equal to 0. That means, yes, it is a factor. Check here. So, here if I'll check, 4 into 2 square, which is 4 into 4, which is 16 plus 2 minus 2. So, it is equal to 16 only, so for this not. So, only for the first one we will say x is equal to 2 is a root, or x minus 2 will be a factor. Right? So, no need to, you have to know, don't have to do the factorization here. If they are giving you that proof, check that whether this is a factor or not. Just find out the root and find the value of that polynomial at that point. Right? So, let's move ahead now. And the next question will be this. Acha. So the next question is, by actual division, find the quotient and the remainder when the first polynomial is divided by the second polynomial. This polynomial has been divided by the other part. Okay, this is the question. So what we will be doing? We will be dividing it. Okay, so x raised to the power 4 plus 1 has to be divided by x minus 1. Okay, now let us find out. So I have told you that what we will be doing, we will be creating the highest power of x here, from here, right? So what we need, let us create the highest power of x from here. So we'll be getting, how to create x raised to the power 4 from x, we will be needing x cube. So you'll be getting x raised to the power 4 multiplication, and x into minus 1 will give you minus x cube, which we are writing separately. Then divide, subtract, add, this got cancelled, you are left with x cube plus 1. How to create x cube from x? Multiply with x square. So you'll be getting x cube plus 1 minus this got cancelled, sorry, x cube, and minus 1 into x square will become x square minus x square, so plus 1. This got cancelled, so you are getting x square plus 1. Now what we'll do, how to create x square? By plus x. So you'll be getting x square, then 1 into minus x is minus x, minus plus, got cancelled, x plus 1. How to create x plus 1 from this x? So just multiply with 1. So you are getting x minus 1. Now let us subtract them, minus, and here it will become plus. So this got cancelled, and 1 plus 1 will be giving you 2. Okay, so what we did here, here we have got x, and then we have got plus 1, which we are carrying from here, this part. Now, if I multiply, I want to eliminate x. So when I eliminate x, I will multiply with 1 only. So this will give me x minus 1. Now change the sign, so 1 plus 1 will become equal to 2. So I got here that, sir, my quotient is x, not question. It, no, many will think, sir, it is question you are writing. Not question I am writing. It is quotient. Okay. So my quotient is x cube plus x square plus x plus 1. And my remainder is 2. My remainder is 2. Okay, so this is the easy problems of division algorithm. So next class we'll be doing the remainder theorem and all the portions which is left, right? So I hope all of you have enjoyed today's session as well. And let's move on to the homework for today's class. So class, this is your homework. This is your homework for today's session. And this is the homework for today's session, and those who will be giving me correct answer in the comment box, their name I'll be featuring in the next session of our video. Also, I have told you that any doubts if you are getting, which you are think are not able to solve, and the good doubts I will also feature in my video next time, that these were the doubts asked by the students. Okay, so this is your homework. All of you can take a note of these questions, and now let's move ahead, class. So all of you, You have just go through the Vedantu's app, which you have already seen. So in that case, you are getting free master classes. There also, you are getting doubt solving support and everything you are getting in that app. So do download Vedantu's app. Okay. And like, share and subscribe to this video. Also press the bell icon so that you will be getting the notification that when the classes are happening at this channel. All of you know that we are conducting the classes almost daily. We are getting classes for 9th, for 10th. Okay. Also, for any queries, you can also reach me at gopal.paliwal@vedantu.com, and all of you know I will respond to them as quickly as I can. Okay, so I hope all of you have enjoyed this session, class. So I'll see you soon in the next session. Till then, bye bye, good night, take care. I'll see you soon.